Home Away From Home, that was Uganda's story of the third round of the Africa Cup of Nations qualifying game. The Uganda Cranes hosted their Group F clash with Tanzania in Egypt. FUFA President Moses Magogo said the missing home advantage was a huge price to pay as they were slumped to a 1-0 defeat.
Across all of Africa, everybody knew you don't go to Mandela National Stadium in Kampala and come out of it.
The Mandela National Stadium in Nambole has been Uganda's fortress. However, CAF banned its use for continental matches in 2020. CAF new stadium regulations demanded major upgrades.
The key areas are four, which is the dressing room, the pitch, the floodlights, and the media facilities, and the venue operation center.
It's been 7 years since the renovation started, but there is a lot of work to do. The government, through Minister of State for Education and Sports, assured the public all pending work on the stadium would be completed before the next qualifying game in June.
We had been given the assurance by the Honorable Minister of Sports that our home ground, Mandela National Stadium, would be ready. And yesterday, before submitting the venue, we made a visit to Mandela National Stadium. And we've since found that they won't be in a position to give us the facility before the date as required by CAF.
Uganda already faces a desperate quest to qualify for next year's competition in Ivory Coast. Unbeaten group leaders and 2019 Africa defending champions Algeria, who have already qualified for the finals, will be their next opponent. About the promise to have the game played at Mandela National Stadium, Magogo indicated there's been sloppy progress and the work being done is shoddy. Magogo indicated there is no genuine progress and the current contractors should be stopped immediately.
When you look at the progress of work, there's no significant update that is going on as far as the construction is concerned. From where we sit as a federation, we believe that construction of a stadium is a specialized type of engineering. We do not believe that the current contractors and the supervising entity are in a position with the experience required to put the stadium to what it is. So the earlier government and the supervisory ministries of works and education, the earlier they took the decision to ensure that we have proper contractors, we have proper supervisors, we might end up not only doing a bad job but also taking too long to finish it and also maybe expensively.
The Cranes are currently left on points with Tanzania and 3 points better than Group F's bottom side Niger, and with 2 rounds to end the qualifiers, it's a case of paying for everything, whether home or away.
And Rogers Mato down to the outstretched left. Enough to make it 1-0. And put Uganda level on 4 points with their counterparts.